lucky who decided to show.
Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brok. It's talking to me! It's Andvari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake, but then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff? Andvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools, and one beaut of a hammer. He make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Andvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone.
Hey Brok, could you take a look at this?
What you got for old Brok? See, you boys ran afoul of some travelers. Or them travelers ran afoul of you, more like.
Who are they? What do they want?
Dunno! Oh, you ask a lot of questions. What's got you all bum-fuzzled over there? Get going! To work it is. Okay, if that'll hold you for now. Good stuff. What's it gonna be? Something for the boy? Now, what was the other thing?
Andvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that.
Up ahead.
ready if you are.
Better at this. Andvari says this dwarf was part of his crew, that he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
He did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. Cannot be trusted.
Huh!
Go!
Silence that ring, boy.
I don't know how.
Boy.
Treasure map. All right. Soul leader.
And a traveler. Guard up.
Right there! Soul Eater. What's a Soul Eater even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore. He says this chest will trigger a bunch of traps.
I see no traps.
Sounded so sure about it.
Right behind it! Who's
Nina?
Workshop is up there. But I know. Don't trust the talking ring.
Potential boy.
please, just listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his lab, and he's sorry he kept trying to trick us. His hammer is just through this gate.
Boy.
Sir. Okay. That's going in the journal. Keep him?
We will talk to the blue one. This is a fine hammer.
Andvari says thank you.
To find that hammer, or you too busy looting every keyhole and cranny?
Here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Andvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it. Sure, I'm open. You take care now.
Mimir, is there a story for the giant with the flaming sword?
Suart the Brave. Of course. We've spoken so much of frost giants. It's about time we instead met the most fiery giant of all. Back when Ymir first emerged from Ginnungagap, it was Suart who followed next. He came from Muspelheim, the Fire Realm, bringing heat to the young cosmos, conjuring the sun from his primordial flame. But let's come back to that flaming sword, shall we? Suart the Brave forged his sword of flame for one purpose alone. To burn down Asgard when Ragnarok comes at last. His destiny is to fall at the hands of Thor and Odin, but in so doing, strike the blow that leaves their realm in ash and ruin. And from that destruction, the world can be born anew. Until then, alone he waits in Muspelheim, never sleeping, ever honing his fiery blade. Brave, generous Suart, who knows he lives but to his doom. All because he chooses to serve a grand cycle so much bigger than himself. To truly embrace your purpose and the patience and sacrifice it demands is to ensure your day will come.
Do you think we'll be there? When that day comes?
I've seen enough of war between the gods. But you, little brother, who can say?